Good afternoon, students. We continue from where we had left the tutorials of demonstration topics of norma basalis. Now remember one thing, this norma basalis tutorial topic which I am discussing with you, kindly repeat it and revise it many times, because base of the skull, whatever foramens, whatever structures passing through it, whatever are the attachments in around this base of the skull across various areas, they are always asked in vivas and practical examination. And base of the skull, the entire base of the skull is very important as far as the head and neck skeletal framework is concerned. So therefore it is my request to all of you, my students, that kindly repeat and revise all these segments, because each and every segment is very important from your viva and practical point of view. So we start with, from where we had left, we start with the lateral part of the norma basalis intima in the middle cranial fossa. Middle cranial fossa, we had finished the median segment. Now we are left with the two lateral segments of the middle part of middle cranial fossa, norma basalis intima. So in the middle cranial fossa, lateral part, it is made up of mainly three bones. What are those three bones? Number one, this portion is greater ring of sphenoid. Very clearly you are able to mark out. Second portion will be, if you can easily mark this, this much is the inner side of squamous portion of temporal bone. Inner side of squamous portion of temporal bone, second portion. And third portion will be, again very clear you are able to mark out, this is the petrous portion of temporal bone. This much is the petrous portion of temporal bone. So these three bones will make up the lateral part of the norma basalis intima in the middle cranial fossa. Now straight away coming to this fissure which is present here, which is present between lesser wing of sphenoid, this is lesser wing of sphenoid, and greater wing of sphenoid, this is superior orbital fissure. Now this superior orbital fissure present between lesser wing of sphenoid, superiorly, inferiorly, the greater wing of sphenoid, and medially, this segment is of course the entire body of sphenoid. So superior orbital fissure, there will be various structures which will pass through superior orbital fissure. What are those structures? In viva, you have to answer like this. The superior orbital fissure is divided by common tendinous ring of Zinn. Now, exactly in the middle, there will be common tendinous ring of Zinn, which will carry the extraocular muscles. The extraocular muscles of the eyeball are attached there. So therefore, this common tendinous ring of Zinn, which is attached in the middle part of the superior orbital fissure, will divide the entire superior orbital fissure into lateral, middle and medial segments. Lateral, middle and medial segments. Now, the structures passing through the lateral part of superior orbital fissure. From the lateral part of superior orbital fissure, the following are the structures. Please note down. Lacrimal nerve, frontal nerve, trochlear nerve, then superior ophthalmic vein, then lacrimal branch of middle meningeal artery, and recurrent meningeal branch of ophthalmic artery. These are the structures passing through the lateral part of superior orbital fissure. Structures passing through the middle part. From the middle part of superior orbital fissure, the following are the structures. It will contain the superior and inferior divisions of oculomotor nerve. Then in between these divisions, nasociliary nerve. And below all the three divisions, abducens nerve. Then we come to this medialmost part. From the medialmost part of superior orbital fissure, inferior ophthalmic vein. Now please note down all the structures here in superior orbital fissure. You need to understand, you need to by heart these structures, because these structures can be asked in one liner question answer also. They can be asked in MCQs, so many MCQs. For example, they can be asked like, lacrimal nerve will pass through lateral part, middle part, medial part or superior part. That means lateral part of superior orbital fissure. Same way, inferior ophthalmic vein will pass through the following part of superior orbital fissure, superior, inferior or medial, or maybe lateral. So it, inferior ophthalmic vein will pass through the medial part of superior orbital fissure. Likewise, there are so many questions which can be asked. So please remember the structures passing through superior orbital fissure, whatever I have discussed with you. Then we come down to greater wing of sphenoid. In this greater wing of sphenoid, we will start with this foramen. This is foramen rotundum. So what is the structure passing through foramen rotundum? Maxillary nerve. Maxillary nerve will pass through foramen rotundum. Even here, this is foramen rotundum. Then the next foramen will be foramen ovale. This foramen ovale we have already discussed during norma basalis extrema. Then just for the sake of revision, what are the structures passing through foramen ovale? Mandibular nerve, accessory meningeal artery, lesser petrosal nerve and emissary vein. Then posterior lateral to foramen ovale is foramen spinosum. What are the structures passing through foramen spinosum? Middle meningeal artery, middle meningeal vein and meningeal branch of mandibular nerve. That is nervus spinosus. Then sometimes in between foramen ovale and spinosum, sometimes very rarely a small canaliculi will be present, and that canaliculus is called canaliculus innominatus if it is present between foramen ovale and foramen spinosum. In those rare cases, that canaliculus innominatus, if it is present, it is always present between foramen ovale and foramen spinosum, and there will be always, if it is present, there will be passage of lesser petrosal nerve. So in those cases, lesser petrosal nerve will pass through canaliculus innominatus instead of passing through foramen ovale. Then we come to medial to foramen ovale. So medial to foramen ovale, there may be presence of very small minute foramen, which is called foramen of Visalius, which will be known as foramen of Visalius. Very small minute here canal, which will be known as emissary sphenoidal canal or foramen of Visalius. Even here, if this is foramen ovale, then here this will be emissary sphenoidal foramen or foramen of Visalius. Then through this canal there will be passing of emissary vein. This emissary vein will connect the pterygoid venous plexus with that of cavernous sinus. Then we come down to foramen lacerum. Of course, this is foramen lacerum. And we know what are the structures passing through foramen lacerum. Even that we have discussed. Then just for the sake of revision, the following structures will pass through it. For example, internal carotid artery will pass through carotid canal and will enter directly through foramen lacerum into the cavernous sinus. It will pass outside, not outside, but inside the cranial cavity through this foramen lacerum. That is internal carotid artery, along with its sympathetic plexus. Then meningeal branch of ascending pharyngeal artery, structure number 2, passing through foramen lacerum. Structure number 3, emissary vein. And structure number 4, greater petrosal nerve combines with deep petrosal nerve to form nerve to pterygoid canal, which will be within the foramen lacerum only. So within this foramen lacerum, these two nerves, greater petrosal combines with deep petrosal to form nerve to pterygoid canal, which will pass through the anterior wall of foramen lacerum, where it has the presence of pterygoid canal. So nerve to pterygoid canal will pass through pterygoid canal, which will be present in the anterior wall of foramen lacerum. Now we pass on to the inner side of squamous portion of temporal bone. This is the inner side of squamous portion of temporal bone. Now here, both the sides, you will see these markings. If you are able to see these markings on both the sides, this is the marking of, now this marking, see here, exactly it is coming from foramen spinosum. From foramen spinosum, this marking is coming. How beautiful this marking is there. And this marking is nothing but middle meningeal artery. As from foramen spinosum, this groove for middle meningeal artery, this is the groove for middle meningeal artery, it will pass till middle of zygomatic arch. Supposing here, this is the middle of zygomatic arch, roughly corresponding inside to this level. Now from here, it will divide, this groove is dividing into two parts. Number one, this is the anterior part, and number two, this is the posterior part. So therefore, from here, middle meningeal artery will divide into anterior branch, which will pass till the pterion. This point is pterion. On the outside, we know the pterion, H-shaped suture, where the four bones are meeting. So anterior division of middle meningeal artery going towards pterion, and posterior division of middle meningeal artery, which will go towards the supramastoid crest. Where is supramastoid crest? This is supramastoid crest. So therefore, roughly corresponding to supramastoid crest, this posterior division of middle meningeal artery will pass posteriorly. So this is the inner part of squamous portion of temporal bone. So two bones we have discussed. One is the greater wing of sphenoid, including superior orbital fissure and all the foramens. Second part is the inner side of the squamous portion of temporal bone with middle meningeal artery and its markings. Now third point will be coming up in the next segment, will be this, the petrous portion of temporal bone.